In space, no one can hear you scream, unless you have proximity chat turned on. Welcome back, my fellow gamers. This is Top 10 Gaming, and I'm your host, Amanda McKnight. Today, we'll be discussing all the fun mod roles that can liven up your game of Among Us. Some of these already exist and can be downloaded as mods to make your game more intricate and, at times, chaotic, whereas others are fan-made and waiting for someone to turn them into exciting modded roles or incorporate them into Among Us Discord bots where possible. I'm looking at you, anyone out there that wants to do that and then let us know in the comments where it is so we can check it out. Join me as we count down the top 10 Among Us custom roles. I love custom roles in deception and social deduction games. So great. Okay, ready, set, let's get counting. Number 10, the cleaner. This is an imposter sub role. I have always thought the idea of imposter sub roles would be super cool to play with personally, as it's already hard enough to be an imposter if you are going solo. And if you happen to be playing with some mega experienced, high IQ players, you could also have sub roles that give imposters a bit of a disadvantage too, to make sure the game is more challenging for whoever ends up in that role. The cleaner role gives the imposter it belongs to a one-time use power where they can hide one of their kills from the group, meaning that unless someone caught them in the act or called an emergency meeting, they wouldn't even know that their crewmate is missing, giving the imposter potentially a little more time to sneak around and at the very least leaving the crew with less information in regards to where the murder took place. The cleaner is an imposter role and they win along with their team if the imposter or imposters secure a victory. Number 9. The body snatcher. This player can swap bodies with any other player once every 2 minutes of gameplay time. Their goal is to make sure they end up on the winning player's team by the end of the game. They're not allowed to swap with someone they have already swapped with though, so they are limited to how many times they can actually swap bodies. While inhabiting a new body, they gain the role and abilities of that color, while the player who they swapped with gains the role and abilities of the body snatcher's previous body. A body snatcher who has now become an imposter but was once a crewmate might be ratted out by the crewmate but could also claim that that player is lying. This one is better played with typing instead of discussing audibly during meetings. Because obviously if somebody's like, I'm blue, and you're like, wait, isn't that Sarah's voice? Then, you know, it's kind of all exposed. Number 8, the glitch. This role makes one crewmate appear as though they are an imposter to the others when really they're not. They do not know who the other imposters are, but will likely be treated differently than other players, so can try to use this information to suss it out. Their win condition remains the same as the rest of their crew, but they now have a bit of an in as to who the imposters could maybe be, as the imposters will potentially treat them differently, like I said. Of course, imposters could also be cautious if they know this role has been incorporated into the game, but that also just makes it harder for them, so I don't know. Number 7, the Oracle. This Oracle role gives one player the ability to see the role of one other player in the game. This is a role best used with other roles in play, as otherwise the only info you could have it set up to acquire is imposter or not, which really isn't as fun, as uncovering the imposter or not is really what Among Us as a game is all about. At the beginning of the game, the Oracle gets secret randomized information sent to them, which provides them with one color's true role and allegiance. The Oracle can then choose to share this information or keep it secret, or if you have proximity chat on, can share it with some, but not with all. Watch out though, other players are allowed to claim that they are the Oracle and can claim to know a role falsely. The Oracle is a crewmate role who wins with the crew if they get a victory. Number 6, the Sheriff. The Sheriff has a very important role. It's their job to try and not only catch the imposter, but to eliminate them as well. Well, they don't explicitly have to catch the imposter in the act, but they do need to be quite certain the person they are targeting is in fact the guilty party. That's because they have an ability that allows them to shoot and kill the player they most suspect as the imposter. However, if they are wrong in their selection and kill an innocent crewmate, they themselves are also eliminated. Number 5, the doctor. While I think this role is really cool, I think it would be a lot cooler if it was more of a Doctor Who kind of modded role than an actual medical doctor. I want a Time Lord modded Among Us game. Give it to me! The doctor role in the game grants one player the power, the responsibility, to mend their fallen crewmates and bring them back to life. I feel like you're more of a necromancer if you're bringing people back from the dead than a doctor, but very well. Maybe they are a doctor that is skilled in the dark arts. Who am I to judge? The thing about this role that makes it a little bit more convoluted is that crewmates who are revived by the doctor are not allowed to talk about who killed them, but obviously get to keep that knowledge because you can't, like, wipe your brain or anything like that, which can be really tricky to navigate when a meeting is called. As whoever a murdered and revived player seems the most suspicious of is likely the imposter, because it's like you can't say that they're the imposter, but you're also gonna, you're gonna be suspicious of them because they killed you. Of course, this makes it all a little bit more convoluted as well if you know the crewmate is murdered, which, of course, I guess you might not. The doctor can choose to reveal themselves and walk around with a huge target on their back, or they can keep their identity a secret. But also, anyone can claim to be the doctor, even if they're not, including the imposters. If you're wondering how the doctor revives people, this role does require a mod to be incorporated, which would give the chosen player a revive button, which they can use to heal dead crewmates. Number 4, the assassin. This is another role created by the user who goes by the name Laud the Fraud on Reddit. The assassin will be given a target player as well as a dossier that contains proof of their innocence, to be used when playing with another custom role. Their goal in the game is to eliminate their target and ensure a crewmate victory. They can eliminate their target by trying to get the imposter to kill them, or by helping to get them voted out, thereby killing them by tossing them out into the coldness of space. The assassin gets a minor victory if they die or lose to the imposters after their target has successfully been eliminated, and they lose if they fail to eliminate their target. After they have eliminated their target, they must reveal to the rest of their group their role, but not before, and also thereby reveal their innocence. It's cheating for anyone else to try and falsely claim that this is in fact their role in the game, if you're playing with this role. I mean, if you're not playing with this role, it'd be really weird if you claimed to be it, because we'd be like, but we're not playing with, wait, what? Number 3, the Syndicate. The Syndicate adds a third faction to the game called, well, the Syndicate. Here, two players are randomly selected to be members of the Syndicate. It is touted as being one of the most complex roles, which is why I love it so much, personally. I love when things are complex. The Syndicate's goal is to ensure the imposters win the game, but the one remaining Syndicate player is the last player left standing when that happens. If this condition is met, both imposters and crewmates lose, and it is actually the Syndicate who wins. I like to think that from there, the Syndicate would actually be able to take hold of the imposters and be able to use them for their own insidious plots. I like to think of them as some kind of like diabolical organization, like Team Rocket. Gotta steal all those imposters and then use them for your own means. But the bot message sent to the Syndicate members, however, actually implies that they're working for a rival company who wants the imposters to succeed in eliminating the crew, as it also serves their best interests. The Syndicate have to walk the fine line of trying to help the imposters win, but avoid having both of them eliminated before the end of the game, and need to be careful, as if the imposters suspect their true allegiances, their goal will likely be to kill them off sooner to prevent them from winning. Number 2, the Jester. This is a role where you actually want to die, no strings attached. It's the Jester's aim to try to get their fellow players to think that they're the imposter, or one of them at least, and vote them out. A game can get pretty crazy too if you happen to end up playing with more than one Jester, and pretty confusing as to who the real imposter is. I like this role a lot, as it makes the game much more layered and helps out the imposter team quite a bit. It's hard being an imposter, so in my opinion, the Jester helps to kind of balance out the game a bit in terms of difficulty, because it's a little easier for imposters to be sneaky here, although obviously if a Jester gets kicked out, then they win. Although I'm not saying it's easy being a crewmate either here, and less so in fact when you happen to be playing with one or more Jesters trying to convince you that they're the imposter, because you're like, wait, who's the what, who am I, huh? Number 1, the detective. This is a really neat role and probably my personal fave. Created and released at the same time as the assassin in the syndicate role, it's the detective's job to help investigate and suss out who could actually be the imposter or imposters. They come armed with a few abilities and tools at their disposal to help them that they can use along their journey. One being their handy dandy notebook, which they can use to jot down clues and record important information. 30 seconds into the game, they'll be able to access and use their notebook. They also have a one-time use ability which allows them to tell if someone is actually doing a task or is faking it. And they come equipped with their own map, similar to the one you see in Admin, which allows them to see where everyone is at any given time. What are your favorite custom roles? Do you have any creations of your own when it comes to custom roles that you'd love to see added to the game? Are you hoping the airship map update also integrates the ideas of some of these mods into core play mechanics? Or do you just prefer original Among Us without any fancy roles? Let us know in the comments below. Thank you so much for watching. This has been Top 10 Gaming, and I'm your host, Amanda McKnight, reminding you to keep on gaming on. Pew pew! I don't have any lipstick on my teeth, right? I'm always so paranoid about that. No, I'm good? Okay. Especially with like black lipstick. It's really obvious. It is touted as being one of the... touted? Is that how you say that? I was gonna say tooted, but that's not right. Touted is right, I believe.